In this mini lesson, we will be answering the essential question, what can I expect to happen when guided reading groups begin? The objective is to establish routines and procedures for guided reading and independent reading. Invite students to the gathering place, and then reflect with them about how reading workshop is going. Celebrate as a class the progress you've made and discuss the importance of being an independent reader. Think, how can we get better as readers? What is one thing you have learned as a reader these past few weeks? Turn to a partner and share your thinking. Give students 2 to 3 minutes to share with each other about their learning. If students are struggling, have them refer to charts, responses, etc. It is important for actors or musicians to rehearse before they perform. What happens during a rehearsal? Today, we will be rehearsing for what will begin happening next week. We will continue our independent reading, but instead of your teacher doing assessments or circulating around the room, your teacher will be leading guided reading groups. Let's review the expectations we have during guided reading. Respect the learning of the students in a guided reading group by not interrupting. If you have a question, quietly seek an answer from a classmate. If you need to get a book from the library, be stealth. When your group is called, come quietly, quickly, and prepared. You should always bring your reading notebooks and a pencil to the guided reading table. What else? Do you have any other suggestions for maintaining a learning atmosphere during reading workshop when guided reading is occurring? Your teacher will continue to conference with students after guided reading groups. Students should be prepared to answer questions about their books. Remember that you should complete at least 2 boxes on your think mark. Reading is thinking, and the expectation is to be putting into practice the good behaviors we've listed together out on the chart. Thinking about your schema, what we refer as prior knowledge or experience, and making connections can help you better understand the book that you're reading. Today, when you buzz, you will be sharing text to self, text to world, and text to text connections with each other. During our independent practice time, students should begin reading from the books that they have selected. The goal is to have 45 minutes of sustained reading. You and your teacher will rehearse what it's like to be called to your guided reading group. You will go over expectations, what will be happening during guided reading, and what students will need to bring each time. This will also be a great time for your teacher to answer questions that you may have about guided reading or independent reading. This day is not designed to do a guided reading group lesson, but to let students rehearse transitioning. Once a group arrives, your teacher will give you feedback on how you transitioned and address any areas that might need to be worked on. If needed, your teacher can send a group away and have them come until they demonstrate that they understand how to transition. If time allows, your teacher may conference with 2 to 3 students once he or she has finished meeting with the guided reading groups. At the end of the reading time, you will complete a written response on a piece of notebook paper. Remember to use your reading response guidelines. Your teacher will give you sufficient amount of time to write. Your teacher will circulate around the room to answer questions or help those who are struggling. You have 20 minutes to write. If you finish early, you may continue to read your books quietly at your seats. And don't forget to record book information in your daily reading log.